Well, everyone, here we go. I'm mixing up a little bit of cobalt blue. And just finding my way back into the painting again, working negative space to create some of these areas of snow. And then hoping to let gravity pull everything downward. I am going to go ahead and put a little burn umber in there. And let it run down the page. Just to get started. I'm keeping my eye on the direction of the snow fall. There are actually two trees here, and this one ends back here. I'm really glad I caught this right now. Here we go. And there's no quick way through this. This is something you just have to settle down and enjoy. Again, we're back to value. We want to suggest and imply I'm using a combination of cobalt and burn umber. So I've gotten that started. Here's the other tree. All right, let's start right here. This is an interesting shape. My frisket or masking, it's still on there, not ready to take it off. And that's a nice big place. The shapes that the snow has on the trees, it's very intriguing. I'm using my number 8 brush, by the way. And what's so nice is when the paper is wet, you can just drop in these colors and gravity will do the work for you. Okay, so we've got another. There'll be plenty to do when I take off the frisket. Let's get over here. We've got this tree, and there's one behind it. We've got this tree. And there's this one is behind this one. So I'm keeping my eye on that area right there. Then we have this tree. Yes, that's where I should have started. I'll have to fix that. Okay, I'm going to get a small brush. I'm going to, this is an 8 also. However, it's got a point. It's got a sketchy pencil point. So this area, okay, now we're moving over here. There's a whole lot of little trees here. So we've got these two, and then there was one back here. What's happening is this is starting to move downhill. I don't know how accurate I am. As to the number of trees, and I'm not sure it really matters. I'm just trying to get a feel for what's going on there. And it's still a little rough, but I'm starting to see it. Now let's go right into this area right here. So we've got the big tree, the smaller tree, and then right in here, okay, there's this tree. And then there is a path back here. So this is the horizon line. Okay, I wanted that in there. And there's a whole bunch of little trees. Oh, okay, so there is, I got it. I have to clear the path back here. And I can do that. So this is gonna come out. And the good news is it should easily work. Okay. So what we have here is the beginning. We're starting to see the structure. I'm using my big brush. This tree peeks through. That's good. We got that in. And then there's a nice big branch, and we'll just put it in, but it's right here. We're gonna let this dry a little. And just so you know, when we get back into this, we're going to start working at the bottom a little, just to take away some of the intensity of all that observation on the top. But we're gonna start to figure out what is going on down here in the way of light and snow. And how it's laying up against the trees. So this is my relief after trying to see what was going on with the trees. I'm also going to take off the frisket. So when you see this next, it will be without the frisket. And that should help us see all the light. There are many values down here in this snow, and we're going to try to see as many of them as we can. Okay, everyone, we're back in. Next time, this frisket will be gone, and we'll get more done.